Hello, I am Dr. Kodlady Surendra Shetty, Consultant Spine Surgeon at Spine Care and Ortho Care Hospital, Magdi Road, Rajajinagar, Bangalore. So in disc surgery, especially in lumbar region, we have option of removing a portion of the protruded disc and maintaining the rest of the disc. So that we call as a simple discectomy, microscopic discectomy or endoscopic discectomy. But in cervical spine, these options are less. 90% of the cases, we have to go from front and remove the whole of the disc tissue. So once we remove the whole of the disc, there is an empty space there. So it collapses. So for that, what we do is, we usually do a cervical fusion procedure that is called ACDF, anterior cervical discectomy and fusion. These are the standard procedures. But what happens if it is a single disc, we can do a ACDF without any problem. But when it's a multiple level, if you do fuse more than two or three segments, then there will be considerable amount of lessening of the movements of the cervical spine that we don't want. So even when there is a more stiffness in the spine, there will be adjacent segment degeneration and next disc may get weaken. So to prevent that, nowadays we do artificial disc replacement. So these discs are like, they give the support to the spine. The wherever we remove the disc, we can place this. They bridge that space without losing movement. They can do bending movements as almost as equal as that of a normal disc. So in cervical disc, especially, this has become a good surgery. But in lumbar disc, it has been tried before, but it has been found that it is not of much advantage over traditional fusion surgery. So that is why nowadays we don't do much of lumbar disc replacement. But in cervical spine, we do disc replacement, especially when there is a more than one level involvement of the disc.